What's going on, guys? We are back. This is more NCAA football 14 dynasty mode. Best offense versus the second best defense.
Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Game time, baby.
Many people say the SEC is the best conference in college football. Well, today's game will determine the champion of that conference. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He sends this one deep.
Harris kicks it away. Burks.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
That's almost picked off.
Guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinators. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25. And he just gets rid of it.
First down.
The 42-yard line. Good gain on the pass to the running back.
Patrick Harris is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
First down, 10 to go. All on their own 42.
That'll make it second and seven.
From their own 45-yard line, it's second down.
And 43.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. Man, that one snuck out by the start. It could have been an even bigger
one. Jack.
Go, Here's third and 9. Ball on the 43-yard line. He's under pressure.
And it's Harris in the middle. They lost him.
Around the 41-yard line.
Best offense in the nation.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made at the 31.
That brings up second and 1.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. He's scrambling. Deep ball.
End zone touchdown.
He caught it. Touchdown.
Matt Wilson. Finds the end zone. Yeah, we knew they were going to score points.
And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 74-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Bray has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. The pitch, and now he's got the corner.
Williamson
tackled after positive yardage. Good gain by the tailback of about 7 on the option play.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Throws down the middle.
Over the middle. Caught!
He's tackled at the 41-yard line.
Once his guy gets into the secondary, he can be a real problem to bring down. He can shake off a lot of tacklers who are smaller than he is.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 41. He's got it with room to run. Tackle at the 28-yard line.
A really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Away here on second down. There he goes. Nice run to the left.
He couldn't quite get the outside.
His defense. I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs and they're executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
Quick throw.
Beverly.
And they make the stop right around the 6-yard line.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
First and goal, and a touchdown ties it, folks.
And he's in!
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. LSU is ready to kick it away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Quick pass. They'll bring him down at the 24-yard line.
And Patrick Harris and Georgia will have the punt.
Cooper, the return man. He really got a hold of that one. Cooper fields it to 31. He's taken down at the 47. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
Well, that's almost passed.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47. They'll spread the field with five wide.
And it's clean over the middle.
And down he goes, around the 25-yard line.
Reggie Clayton. Hey, that's right. Now we've got some tables.
And he tackles him hard at the 10-yard line. From the 10-yard line, it's first down. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. Receivers
playing still on his feet.
And he's taken down right around the 8-yard line. He makes the PAT. A five play, 53 yards, and they put up 7 points.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient at throwing the ball.
So our score, 14-7. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they cannot put this up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
Black Ivy!
Miller goes with a play fake. Slings it. He's taken down at the 42. From their own 42-yard line. First down. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he is drilled at the 50-yard line.
Jeff Herter. Second down, Georgia.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Caught with room to work.
Brooks.
And he's finally shoved out at the 12.
Think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line.
Edwards touchdown.
Tremendous example of the type of chemistry that these two players enjoy. When a quarterback and a receiver are on the same page, good things tend to happen.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game.
And he splits
the uprights with the extra point. Georgia lines up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 10. He's tackled at the 24. A touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with a nice run and pass look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
So at the end of one, we're deadlocked right now at 14. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 50.
Will Walker.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation.
That's picked.
Coverage and it's intercepted.
By Benjamin.
Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
From their own 40-yard line. Second down. Gives it up the gut. He gets out to about the 42-yard line.
Motion, motion, motion.
it to the halfback on the screen. And he's leveled at the 47-yard line. They get 5 yards on the play.
It's a well-designed play to the halfback, and it worked at least to get them a medium gain on the play.
4th and 3.
Palmer awaits the snap.
Defense coming up clutch.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
And Williams is the 21. Eaten up.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. Gets it. He's in space. He's tackled at about the 25-yard line. A pickup of 4 on the play.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
Complete. That's a great tackle at the
30. Well, that's a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set and a defense anticipating pass here. Gets it on the
line. That's an alien in the old game.
Around the 47-yard line. From their own 47-yard line. First down. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Some open field. Tackle made at the 44.
Any of the
old width. That brings up 2nd and 1. He makes his way to about the 32. From the 32-yard line, it's first down. Play action. He's going to go for the home run.
That's almost a pick.
Intercepted.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
This is the 9th play of this drive. And he's
more down the sideline. It's going to be 1st and goal. First and goal for LSU.
It's 1st down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Taken down behind the line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. And he's tackled around the 3-yard line. That makes it 3. Here we go. Third and goal from the 3-yard line. Throws it in a hurry.
Touchdown!
Will Walker.
In the end zone.
So a 12-play, 79-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook thrust. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 21-14. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Bulldogs quarterback, Kirk, he has done his job. Unfortunately, there's 22 guys on a team, and one guy's doing a great job. The other 21 aren't so much.
Yeah, it's not going the way they had hoped or planned. Right now, you're right, the quarterback's doing what he needs to do to be able to move the ball. But the running backs, the wide receivers, the offensive line, the entire group, they've got to do a better job. Right now, when you look at that scoreboard, they've got to be really frustrated to think that they're down. Now, they still have time to get back in the game, and we'll see if they can adjust their mental mindset.
Quarterback stats are one thing. Winning the game is what's more important. From their own 43-yard line, first down. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense of getting out to that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Here they come.
And Tyrell Miller's going to get sacked.
The Tigers will use their first time out of the half. So they run the ball on third and long.
Well, Brad, here the offense is trying to surprise the defense with a run, but it didn't work.
Cooper will be the return man. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And down he goes at the 26.
Return for a gain of 13 yards.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
LSU is up by a touchdown. Get to that quickly. Very good tackle in space. And he hits him hard at the 45.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long.
56.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts.
And it's Washington over the middle.
They'll bring him down right around the 18-yard line.
How's it Washington?
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. Throws incomplete.
Walker is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 18-yard line. It's second down. They'll line up with five wide receivers.
And touchdown! Isaac Washington.
Making three passes for touchdowns.
The quarterback is just having a great game so far. He's had absolutely no problem finding the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. Harris has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. And he's taken down at the 27. As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. 28-14, LSU. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He makes his way to about the 42.
The Williamson is his biggest run of the game. 27 yards.
First and 10. Ball on their own 42.
A great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
First down, LSU.
He's into the open field. Good outside run there. Good run by the quarterback.
The thing that impresses me is the decision making. He sees it opening, decides to turn it upfield, and gets a nice gain and a first down.
Ball on the 43-yard line. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here.
Nice throw.
There he goes, around the 27-yard line.
Burning through.
From the 27-yard line, first down. The Tigers quarterback down on the sideline after getting injured earlier. I think it looks like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we're going to see him back in the game before the day's over. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. That makes it second and 8. Fletcher comes in at quarterback. Scrambling, and they got him.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 17. Fires quick into the receiver to get the grab. There was not a soul open there.
He threw into double coverage because it was an obvious passing down, and the defense knew the pass was coming.
Kicks from 51.
The kick is up.
The kick is up, and it's good.
And he just drilled it from long range.
31-14.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And they make the stop right around the 36-yard line.
First down for Georgia.
That makes it first and 10.
From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. To about the 37-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
And that's incomplete.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken.
Pass the fucking
out of turnover would have been really big.
From their own 37-yard line, it's third down. And he is drilled.
And Miller gets sacked.
They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Palmer to punt. Booming kick. Cooper fields it at the 27. What a collision. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Pitch out, got the corner. Nice run to the outside. They get about 6 yards on the option to the halfback.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's got it with room to run, and he tackles him hard at the 45-yard line.
First down.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on their own 49. He's tackled at the 48-yard line.
Gain of 3 on the play. Third down.
Man left. Two down.
Mike, 55. Right there.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
Fletcher needs stuff. He's got the punt.
Brooks is back deep to return. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Man,
it's broken up.
You can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 20-yard line. Second down. Brought down right around the 32-yard line.
Mason.
First down.
Time right. get the sack. He's going to get Tyrone Miller's going to get sacked.
He found the path into the backfield and didn't
second
let the quarterback
sack
get away
the game for Brendan Mitchell.
So the sack makes this a second and long. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Game seven on the play. That makes it 3rd and 11.
Gets it to the back. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 37-yard line.
There he goes.
Palmer is waiting for the snap. He really got a hold of that one. Got the corner. He's out to the 30. And they push him out around the 40-yard line. Georgia's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
They're ready to begin another drive.
Fletcher down the sideline.
He's finally knocked out of bounds at the 22. So with one quarter remaining, the Tigers lead 31-14.
Yeah, take as much time as possible.
Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Made at the 21-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up 2nd and 9.
From the 21-yard line, 2nd down. Here's an opening. Williamson off the right side. Nice gain as he works the right side.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Your game.
That brings up 2nd and goal.
Short yardage defense here.
See what you got.
That's a great tackle at the 4.
No gain on the play. That makes it 3rd and goal.
So here we go. It's 3rd and goal from the 3-yard line.
Touchdown.
He's in double digits for touchdown catches this year.
I can see now why this quarterback calls him his favorite target. Whenever this guy's near the end zone, he gets him the ball.
And he hits the PAT. So that's a 7-play, 59-yard drive. They come away with a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is
physically really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Tigers have a defense that's a sight to behold, Kirk.
Well, they just play with a chip on their shoulder. They are all over the field. The defensive line does their job. The linebackers, the safeties, everybody plays as one, and they've been fun to watch today.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
And
the defense had some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. Across the middle.
And that's going to be caught. First down.
49.
Quarterback Jeff Carter. Scenario. He had his man one-on-one on a corner route versus man coverage, and you just saw it. It results in an easy first down.
Just throws this one away.
This is a shutdown zone.
From their own 49-yard line. Second down. Finds his man. First down. They'll bring him down at the 40.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. Tackled for a loss.
Tyrone Brooks.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Gets it. He's in space. And he's taken down around the 23-yard line.
Another third-down conversion.
That makes it first and 10.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 19. Finds his man and they take him down immediately.
Third and one. Hurry up.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. Knocked out of bounds at the 13-yard line.
Well, they didn't need too much on that play. And let me tell you, they didn't have any room to spare because they barely picked up the first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 13-yard line. He's knocked out of bounds at the 17.
That makes it second and 14.
This is the 12th play of this drive. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it third and 11.
They've been 2 for 2 on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. There's a strike complete. They bring him down in the backfield. Georgia's going to use their first time out of the half here. So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. Slings it. He's in for the conversion. It and he's got the corner and he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Runs right for a nice game. The Bulldogs use their second timeout.
Georgia.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. We have less than a minute to go. He's taken down at the 28-yard line. Georgia will take their final timeout. Your quarterback, take a knee. It's fourth down, so the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. He gets it up,
and he missed it.
And he missed it left. No good. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. And they'll try one last pass here to pad the stats, but that's about all they're going to get right here. And they got him. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, LSU 38, Georgia 22.
Two rushing for Georgia.
We are playing number two TCU in the national championship. My first year in charge of LSU, we were going to the Natty. And the coaches poll were number two. Media were number one. Yeah, so every outlet has a different top two. Three. Going 7 touchdowns, 11 interceptions. Receiving the one hit 1,000. Which Beverly's still well if he... Brandon Mitchell with 9 sacks. So far in the year. He's in one more game. This is the depth chart. I think they made it hard for the draft, actually. Michael Woods.
DTs are leaving. Simpson's leaving, Wright's leaving. Yeah, I think we're good. Pretty good. Mitchell hasn't played yet. He's on the very high end. Hope y'all enjoyed everyone.